Hello everyone, welcome to On The Media. I'm Henry Kondo and I'm here with...
Aiden.
Gavin Sarvis.
I'm Eli.
Today we'll each be talking about interviews that we did with close family with family members or someone close to us. Let's all start out with talking about who we interviewed and why.
Yeah, so I interviewed my grandmother. She's 78 years old, Linda Hughes. I chose to interview her because of her life experience, and I was visiting her over spring break, so I thought it was a great opportunity.
I decided to interview my mother, Callie Haney. I decided to interview her because she lived in like an average income family growing up, so I got a real perspective on what life was like 45 years ago.
So I interviewed my grandmother, Barbara Schrader. She's 80, and I decided to interview her because she's been through all the different types of media, and she used to work at a phone company growing up in high school.
I decided to interview my academic advisor, Lynn Gallagher, who's also a professor here at Loras College. She's been a big part of my journey since I transferred here 2 years ago. She helps students with disabilities like myself with making sure we have accommodations we need and whatnot. So now that we got to hear about who y'all interviewed, let's tell me about the technology that your interviewee grew up with.
Yeah, so my grandmother, she grew up in like a real rural area on a farm, so she didn't really have much growing up, but she also had the newspaper, so she developed a love for reading from that, and she had a television in her household. Other than that was really it for media.
My mother grew up in like an average suburb, and she had two houses or two televisions and one house phone that she had to share between her four siblings and two parents.
Yeah, kind of similar. My grandmother grew up with a newspaper and a radio, and she also had a house phone, but the telephone line rang through her entire neighborhood, so she never knew if someone was listening in on her conversation or not.
Well, thank you all for sharing. Miss Gallagher said she usually she grew up with the TV, newspaper, radio. back when she was in college, when it came to registering for classes, it was the exact opposite of now, where you register online. They used to register in person, and then she found out her classes 2 weeks later when they posted classes on a bulletin board or something like that. How has the advancement in technology over the years impacted your interviewee's life?
It hasn't really impacted her too much. She just joined Facebook, which I think is great for her. It helps her stay connected with what's going on in the world. But for her media overall, she uses it as a way to communicate. So keeping in touch with her loved ones is a big effect of media on her life.
Kind of similar with what Aiden said, my parents started to use social media to stay in touch with friends and family, and that was really like the only big step that they took besides having newer TVs and newer models and everything like that.
My grandmother shared with me that made her life a lot easier. For example, she said that writing emails is a lot easier than writing a letter because the emails just correct her mistakes for her, while she has to make the letter perfect, and she would have to end up restarting a lot.
Thank you all for sharing. Miss Gallagher said she's more comfortable with how technology is now. Something she likes to use a lot now is GPS to help her get from place to place driving, and she rarely finds her information on the TV. She usually checks her phone, and I'm the same way. So what were the similarities between you and your interviewee's opinions?
So yeah, we agreed that communication is a big part of media, staying connected with your loved ones, like we've all said. We agree it's a great way to pass time. She enjoys watching the news every single morning. But other than that, media hasn't really been a big part of her life.
Similar with what Aiden said again. My difference was our different uses of social media. She uses it to stay in touch with family and friends, like I said, but I use it more to like scroll through the internet, find funny, interesting videos. But something similar that we found was how much we use it, and like it can kind of like overrun, like you could be caught scrolling for hours on end.
Yeah. So me and my grandmother didn't really have much similarities, but a difference we shared was that she believes my generation doesn't have meaningful face-to-face conversations, but I disagree with her because I don't think that's the case.
Yeah, me and Miss Gallagher, we both agreed that people can become, and particularly the younger generation, can become too attached to their phones, and also how also how people can, you know, believe too much false information. People there's a lot of false information on social media. What were did your interviewee have any thoughts on informational technology and the future, such as AI?
Yeah, we actually did talk about AI and how, like, we see all the possibilities and potential it has and all the benefits it could bring society. But I made emphasis on all the, or actually she made the emphasis on all the dangers that it can present, like phone addiction. I mean, I can personally say I'm addicted to my phone. But yeah, so basically she just mentioned that we need to watch out for all the dangers and be aware.
Yeah, my mother said basically the same thing. She just kept it really short and sweet. She said, AI can be very beneficial, but if used correctly, or very bad if used poorly.
Yeah, along with you, my grandma said that, or she believes AI will eventually run our lives for us, and a quote that she said was, we're not gonna be able to think for ourselves and our brains will eventually shrink.
Yeah. Thank you all for your feedback. And now on to our final question. Do you all feel that your opinion, your perspective on technology has shifted at all in any direction, or do you think it's kind of remain the same with this interview? Me personally, after talking to my interview, I still have the opinion that people can become too attached to their phones and that false information, people spreading false information can be dangerous. So have your views really changed or not really?
Yeah, so my perspective on media hasn't really changed all that much after my interview. I still believe it's a great way to communicate, but after talking to my grandma, it did open my eyes to the fact that we do need to be more aware about all the dangers media can bring.
I also didn't have my perspective really change much because my mother and I basically had the same opinions on everything, besides that she just lived in a different era.
Yeah, my perspective hasn't really changed either. I always thought that media just made our lives easier and more simple.
Well, whether your perspective's changed or remain the same, I think it's great that you all had to were able to have these conversations and you're able to find people who offered you wisdom about how they grew up, about the technology that they grew up with and whatnot, and how they operate in different times compared to nowadays. And thank you all for joining us on the media. It's been great to have a conversation with everyone here. Thank you. Have a great day.